This shopping app is made for and driven by Gen Zs.
It was, oh my gosh, I was so excited to get that first sale. I made 20 bucks, but I mean, it's something.
Depop is taking the sustainable shopping world by storm, boasting more than 30 million users across nearly 150 countries. It's an online hub where people buy and sell reused clothing, vintage shoes, and accessories. Let's take a look at how this trendy app is disrupting the global retail industry. Depop is powered by young influencers like 20-year-old Moira Campos. Her online store, The Rise of Moira, has 40,000 followers, making her one of Depop's top sellers.
I started when I was in high school. I had all these clothes in my closet that I don't use anymore. And I came across this girl on YouTube who would sell her old clothes on Depop to make money. So I started doing that.
Her first sale ever was a vintage Tommy Hilfiger sweater for 20 bucks. Since then, selling clothes on Depop has become a full-time job for Campos. She works with her brother to source, shoot, and sell dozens of items on the app every week.
I started with a $20 capital, but now I would usually spend about $1,000 in inventory a month, and that would generate me, and depends on the season, but it would generate me about $5,000 to $7,000 in a month. It's a lot like Instagram. It's user friendly, so when we open the app, it's not that complicated, not like other selling platforms. It's also our style. Like, most of the people who sell on the app are also Gen Zs.
The U.S. secondhand clothing market is estimated to double to $77 billion within the next 5 years. That's according to online thrift store ThredUp. Depop plays a significant part in that boom. In mid-2021, e-commerce giant Etsy acquired the 10-year-old app for $1.6 billion, seeking to attract younger shoppers. Retail analyst Mary Eppner says Depop could pose a real threat to traditional retailers.
This is really for the younger generation and the things that they would like, and the influencers go here so that they can create one-of-a-kind outfits at a great price.
But there are questions about the ethics of Depop, too. Savvy young sellers who are able to buy clothing in bulk from thrift stores might mark up those items on the online store for twice the price. And as more teens turn to the app to make a quick buck, some fear that sustainability might lose out to profitability. Campos insists that all she hopes to do is give old clothes a second life, and maybe one day create a clothing line of her own.
In 5 years, hopefully I have my own brand, my clothing brand. Maybe I would still be doing Depop on the side just for fun, because it is fun. But definitely in 5 years, I want to have my own brand and selling on my own website.